Make no mistake about it.
There is a release button down here, which is like really hard to see.
This is not a big deal for Sydney Kinney.
You just push it in, and then it just completely like lets the leg go.
The college freshman in her dorm room showing us how quickly she takes off and puts on her prosthetic leg. Watching her on campus here at Indiana University of Pennsylvania, you'd never know she has any issue at all.
I don't, a lot of people just assume that it's like a knee brace or something like that.
She walks like any other student, and that's exactly the way she wants it. She wants no pity, wants no one to feel sorry for her. She stays positive, moving ahead in what she calls her second chance. For the first time, Sydney is talking publicly about the horrifying accident here back on March 20th, 2010. Sydney and her friend Marissa Mazur were riding together on a bike here in West Mayfield near Beaver Falls. With Sydney on the seat, Marissa standing up pedaling, they gained too much speed and careened over the hillside, slamming into this oak tree.
She flew off of the bike and hit headfirst into the tree, and I rolled with the bike down the hill. And I broke both of my femurs, I cracked my hips, I broke a rib, I broke my arm, I broke almost every bone in my foot, and I lost part of my tibia, like this much of my tibia.
The girls suffered severe injuries and were rescued by a Geneva College student.
I literally owe my life to him. If it weren't for him, then I wouldn't be where I am now, and God put him there for a reason, and I'm still here for a reason.
Part of that reason, to honor her friend Marissa, who died 6 days later from brain trauma. Sydney could not attend Marissa's funeral because she was dealing with severe injuries.
She was on a respirator and really was quite ill.
Dr. Timothy Ward said Sydney suffered injuries similar to military combat victims.
She had a very severe opened fracture of her right lower extremity, just a devastating injury, as well as fractures of both of her thigh bones and also of her right shoulder and a pelvic fracture.
Dr. Ward inserted metal rods to save her left leg and most of her right leg, but in the end, he had to amputate. In her long recovery, first at Children's Hospital, then at the Children's Institute, Sydney had to learn how to walk, to climb steps, and to run wearing her prosthetic leg. Pushing herself, she says, with her parents as her backbone and a great support system.
I had a lot of people who were there for me, like through everything. Like, I had my one friend Jocelyn, when I was in rehab, she stayed with me for 2 weeks. She did not go home. She lived in the hospital room with me because, like, that's what I needed. I still can't believe that she did that.
Now, nearly 4 years later, Sydney is driving, exercising. She even plays softball. Her medical team marvels at Sydney's improvements and her will to succeed.
What I think is most unusual here is the way Sydney has responded. I mean, she really, from the day I met her, has had a great attitude. I have never seen her down for 1 second, really. And she's just been a trooper through it all.
That positive attitude is now fueling her career interests.
Let me see you walk once.
Sydney says because of Dr. Ward and the way she was treated in her recovery, she's studying pre-med now at IUP and wants a career in orthopedic medicine, showing her parents that she'll make the most of this second chance.
It's like my goal in life. I just want to, it's all I want to do is like make my parents proud. I'm going to get where I want to go in life.
Right.
Like, it'll all be worth it 10 years from now, whenever I have my dream job.
Dr. Ward says she is well on her way, for sure.
I think that she can do it, and I think it would be tremendous.
Helping others in their journey back.
I think because I have like such a personal connection, so I think if I'd be able to like get into something like this, like say something happened to some like a similar situation, I'd be able to personally connect with like the patient. So
I think you're gonna do it.
Yes, yeah, so I think that'd be really awesome.
Another virtual high five, Sydney. Way to go. The reason Sydney told me she wanted to share her story now, she wants everyone to know that if you keep a positive attitude, you can handle so much more than you ever would imagine.